Today, friends, I've got simple steps to distribute your parts while working in Tinkercad, so let's get cracking. A user reached out saying, hey, why isn't there a line and distribute? I don't have a good reason for that, but let me show you how I get around it. So first, I'm going to hit create new 3D design. Let's click on our name. I always like to change this first. I'm going to just call this disc for distribute. And the problem usually is people have a part like this. You can stretch it out to whatever size you want. To make life easier, I'm going to set this to 100. That's just easier for doing math. I'm going to choose 5 millimeters thick. Of course, you can drag the handles or you can type the values that you want. If you do the black handle, it goes in a single direction, which is nice and easy. If you do the white handles, it does two at a time. If you ever don't like what you did, you can simply do Control Z. I'm going to set this to 35. I do also want to let you know that Tinkercad's got a sweet radius tool. If I put this 3 in here, see how that has weird endings? Check it out. That's because we stretched the handles. If I bring out this part and I type 3 and press enter, check out how nice those corners are. Then if I set the numbers, this would be the 35. This would be the 100. And this would be the 5. You get totally different shapes. So I just want you to know if you drag the handles, you break the parameters. Of course, we're working on a line and distribute. I'm going to delete this one and I'm going to just play with this one right here. So the first thing I'm going to show you, bring out a hole. I like to use shift, squeeze, or stretch to set my measurement. I'm just going to say 5. I'm going to select those two, choose L for align, make this one the boss, and I'm going to align it to the left edge and center. A lot of times I tell you to look at this from a corner so you can see that it's the center of those. This sticks up just high enough, but I'm going to make it 8 so it's easier to grab. And then we're going to use the basic nudge. You could pick any of the numbers you want. For my project, I'm going to do 5. So if I do one click in, I know that's 5 millimeters across. So now I can do Control D, 1, 2. So there's a 5 millimeter gap. And if I do Control D again and again, it spreads out evenly across. But notice the math didn't work out for the entire part. So what I would do is delete that one, hide this one, select all those and do Control G. So now they're a single part. Now when I do show all, I can grab all of those and I can align them to the middle. Not as cool as align and distribute, but you can see it does work. Let me show you another way using the ruler. I'm going to do R for ruler. I want this all to line up right to the 0 point. So when we look at this, you can see this is the dimension of 100, and this is how far it is away. If I type that as a 0, it snaps right to that edge. If I make this green one a 0 as well, and then once again, it shows us our other measurements of 35, 100, and 8 now, because we've got those holes selected. Check this out. If I switch to just the red piece, now you get that 5 for the height that we chose. So with that lined up, let's cut in another part. This time I'm going to bring out a cone. I'm going to set the sides to 6, just because this is kind of cool. Makes a hexagon. Of course, I got to make it a hole. Once again, we're going to use the parameters. I'm going to make the top radius 4. And the bottom radius 1. So now it's more like a funnel. And then I want the height to be 5 so it matches our project. Now at this very moment, it is negative 24 and it's 8 and it's 21 in. So I'm going to set those to 0 and 0 just so you can see it move to the corner. And then this is where we can start being creative. If I knew I wanted this to be 7 millimeters up, I can click, type the 7, and press enter. That distance is now 7. If I wanted it to be from the center, I can click use midpoint. Now it's still giving me the 8 millimeters, but now from this corner, it's 11 millimeters up. I'm going to change this distance to 5. Notice that's way too close, so I'm going to change it to 10. And now I'm going to use that same duplicate trick to space them out. I'm going to click on this shape, do Control D, and I'm going to use my arrow keys to nudge it apart. This time I'm going to go 30. You can see it's telling me the distance from the corner. And if I do Control D again and again, It memorized it, and this time I did my math accidentally, and it turned out perfect. Notice how it just backs up 90, then we take away 20, and 20, and 20. So because of a little math, we were able to make that line up perfectly. So that's how you can use the ruler. Right now I want to make this project larger, so I'm going to change this length to 45. Notice because I used the parameters, it still keeps its awesome radius. I'm going to click and nudge it down one, and let me show you one other trick for adding these holes. If you search for the tool called Grid, I'm going to choose this one right here. Notice there are lots to explore, and what they do is they give you a shape, a radius, a height, a rotation, and then column and row spacing. Of course, for my project right now, I only want one row. I'm going to make 7 for how many they go across. I'm going to keep my 5-sided polygon. I'm going to set the radius at 3. Notice you can change the rotation. Let's just try 45 and see what we think. Interesting, it almost makes the point aim down. I'm going to go back to 0 just because I do like the point of the pentagon pointing up. Column spacing, I'm going to change this to 12. And of course, row spacing doesn't matter because I've only got one. Now I can adjust my columns. Let's make this 6. And I'm going to turn it into a hole. So let's select those quickly and do L for align. I want to make it to the center, and I'm going to make it to the bottom. I'm going to move it up one click. And now we can adjust these. Let's see what it looks like if we do 14. Notice we will have to align it. 15. And then I'm going to select them, choose L for align, and once again make the red one the boss, and bingo, our parts are aligned. If I click on this and made it a 4-sided shape, all of a sudden we'd have squares. Let's change that rotation by 45 degrees just because we can. And bingo, that would give us straight squares. I'm going to select our entire project and let's do Control G to group just to see what we built. I'm not exactly sure what it would be useful for, but those are some techniques for how you can align and distribute using Tinkercad. Friends, as I wrap up, I want to say thanks to Dr. Octothorpe for the question. Absolutely love projects like this. I also want to say thanks to all my supporters on Patreon. I do want to remind you there is a free messaging tool that's part of it. And of course, you can learn more in the description or with the bit.ly up above. Finally, friends, I want to thank you for watching the video. Don't forget, every time you hit that like button, share a video or add a comment down below or even hit subscribe, you're helping HLModTech become a little bit bigger, which absolutely makes my day. Friends, have a glorious day and keep tinkering.